muffled with this technology stuff.
You got plugged in here, Elliot.
Good evening and welcome to Doyle Miller Court for tonight's
Saturday 6
basketball game between the Murray Mustangs and the Colo-NESCO Warriors.
Yeah, if you're on camera, that'd be great.
Please remember Colo-NESCO encourages positive sportsmanship and behavior at our activities. Please encourage players and coaches with positive comments and acts and respect the decision of the game officials. What you do in the same random contest reflects on your team, school, and community. Enjoy the game by being a good sport. Ladies and gentlemen, this time we ask you to rise and move your head.
We'll pause for a minute for the United States National Anthem.
Number 33 in from Murray, and she'll be across from number 32, Michaela Neuendorf. She'll be across from Molly Barton. That's your starting five tonight for the second round of Class 1A Region 6 girls basketball action.
Tonight is beach night for the Royals. There are lays all over the place in the press booth. And
underway, and it will be controlled by Colo-NESCO. Michaela Neuendorf clearing it. Here's Faith Vincent over to her sister. Now back to Faith Vincent at the top of the key. Gets it inside to Neuendorf. Puts up a short-range jumper, and it's good. Colo-NESCO off to a good start. 2-0 lead for the Royals. Here's the inbound against the man press by Colo-NESCO.
Murray's coach yelling at them to get it up the court and to go quick. We'll have a turnover right away.
Wild pass, and that's exactly what Colo-NESCO wants to happen tonight. Force those rush turnovers by Murray. Faith Vincent brings it down the floor for the Royals. She feeds it to the high post to Michaela Neuendorf. Now to Maggie Barton. Kick outside to Rachel Vincent. Back inside. Batted away. Nearly stolen, but cleared by Colo-NESCO. Pass inside. Tipped a bit, but cleared by Salzer, and she lays it up and in. Colo-NESCO takes a 4-0 lead. 7:12 left to play in the first quarter.
This is 33 with the ball.
Murray breaks the press. Now gets it to the top of the key. Now the wing. There's a pass back up to the top of the key to McIntosh. McIntosh now over to Otto. Otto drives in a bit and shit's stolen away by Barton. Colo-NESCO looking to add to their lead here. Here's Vincent pushing it down the floor. Looks to the right side, gets it to Rachel Vincent, back to Faith Vincent. Now to Stalzer on the wing. Now back to Stalzer. She drives in a bit, and that kicks it back outside, and it's stolen away by McIntosh on the tip pass.
Murray wanting to go quick. Their coach is signaling for them to speed it up.
Good inside feed now. Pop back outside. Drives baseline a bit, and that kicks it back out to McIntosh. McIntosh now inside pass to Gossett. Misses the shot, and the rebound cleared by Stalzer. Stalzer bringing it down the floor. Kicks it to Neuendorf on the wing. Back to Vincent. Top of the key. Gets it to Neuendorf on the high post. Puts up a mid-range jumper. No good. And the rebound controlled by Gonsith. And here comes Murray.
Murray's been
stolen away right at the top of the key by Vincent.
Testing.
Here's a pass back up to the top of the key. Inside pass, short corner, pump fake. Gets back out to the wing corner. No good, and the rebound controlled by Molly Barton.
Now? All right.
Now here's the kick. Stalzer for three, no good. Not exactly the range he wants to be shooting from.
I was trying to turn it down because yours was really loud. Work on that a bit.
All right.
Find the perfect.
Now here's a feed inside. Puts up a shot. No good. And Stalzer grabs the rebound. Colo-NESCO pushing it the other way. Stalzer. Cross court pass to Rachel Vincent. She clears it. Now back up to the top of the key to Stalzer. To Neuendorf on the three. She's going to try for it. And it's good.
There we go.
Michaela Neuendorf from the left wing for three. And Colo-NESCO takes an early 9-0 lead. Murray will call a timeout. 4:50 left in the first quarter. Colo-NESCO out and running.
I can hear you. Oh. That's Grace Stalzer with her 200th rebound of the season. Kaylin Neuendorf has 5 of Colo-NESCO's 9 points.
Colo-NESCO out to a great start here. Murray not able to finish down low, which has been their bread and butter this season. But Colo-NESCO forced a couple turnovers in the transition against the press, and here they show it again. We're likely to see that all game. Here comes Murray. Here's the inside feed and cross-court pass. And number 45, Brianna Klein, traveled with the basketball, turning it right back over to Colo-NESCO. Now here's Faith Vincent bringing it down the floor for the Royals. Gets herself a set play, drives to the right side, now gets inside to Barton. She lost control of the ball, and it's stolen away by Gilbert. Pushing it down the floor is Wookie. She drives in a bit, but she lost control, and Barton steals it right back away. Here's Vincent dribbling down the floor to Henze in the corner. Three ball on the way, no good. And the rebound controlled by Gilbert. Wookie drives in, and it was
offensive foul.
Blocked, but a charge will be called on Wookie, giving it right back to Colo-NESCO.
Colo-NESCO working the press well so far tonight. Fouls on Kayla Siefklis. It's her first.
Henze brings it down the floor and now gets it to Vincent. Henze now to the wing. Gets it right back to Vincent. Now to Stalzer on the left wing. Back to Vincent. Vincent over to Henze. Vincent now to Robinson on the high post. Back out to Henze. She drives it baseline. Cross paint pass to Barton up and in on the layup. And Colo-NESCO has an 11-0 lead. Full court press. Henze guarding McIntosh closely. Now back up top. It's the wing to McIntosh. She gets it inside to Gonsith, who puts up a mid-range jumper up and in, and that's Murray's first points, but Colo-NESCO takes it back the other way and fast. Here's Robinson putting up a short-range jumper. No good. And the rebound raked down by Gonsith. Now here comes Murray down the floor.
Murray doing really good on the defensive rebounds after Colo-NESCO misses a shot. You won't see them shoot a lot of threes tonight.
Gonsith kicks it back out up top. Bounce pass inside, and Stalzer reached around.
Be one foul for each team now. Wookie and Stalzer. Faith Vincent and Michaela Neuendorf checking in for the Royals. And Wookie checking back in for Murray.
Here's the inbound. On the wing side, now back up to Wookie at the top of the key. Almost stolen away by Vincent. Getting it back to Otto. Now back to top of the key. High post. Now back out to Otto. That'll be a two. It's no good, and a good rebound by Michaela Neuendorf. She's pushing it the other way. Gets it back to Vincent at the top of the key. Back to Neuendorf. She pump fakes, drives in a bit. Now she'll kick it back out to Vincent. Vincent drives in. Back out to Robinson, puts up a short-range jumper, in and out, no good. And the rebound controlled by Klein. Now here comes Murray down the floor. Mustangs trying to get something going here. Inside pass, shot, no good. And battle for the rebound will be knocked out of bounds. And it will go to Colo-NESCO.
Neuendorf and Barton sent to the deck on that play. Stalls are checking in for Neuendorf.
Colo-NESCO playing excellent defense here early. Now here's Vincent bringing it across the timeline. Gets it to Stalzer, and it's knocked away. And battle for the loose ball will be a jump, and that should go to Murray. That was Katie Otto knocking the ball away as Michaela Neuendorf checks back in for Molly Barton. The pass inbounds, almost lost back out of bounds. Wookie gets it across the court. Might have gotten away with the push off inside feed. Up and good from Klein, and Murray cuts it to an 11-4 lead. Here's Vincent, gets it inside to Stalzer. Stalzer's tied up underneath the hoop, and it's going to be a foul called by the top corner referee.
Fouls on Brandy Gilbert. First.
Vincent inbounding it on the baseline, gets it to Robinson, puts it off the glass too strong, and the rebound will be controlled by Gilbert.
Murray doing really good on the defensive rebounds. I don't think Colo-NESCO's got one offensive board tonight.
Here back up to the top of the key to Gilbert. Now to Otto. Drives baseline. Puts up a floater. No good in the long rebound. Controlled by Robinson. Almost knocked away, but she clears it. Now to Vincent. Here's Rachel Vincent in the corner. Drives in a bit. Now to Grace Stalzer. Short range jumper too strong. And the rebound controlled.
Gonsith.
By Gonsith. Here's a pass to the wing. Looking for an open post feed. They depend on that. Now pass up top to Gonsith. Knocked away. Now here's Otto. Otto looking inside. Gets it back out to Wookie, and a body foul will be called on Faith Vincent there at the top of the key.
Murray's coach is very mad. Jerry Shields screaming at his players.
here's the inbound. Here's Wookie, now gets it down inside. Back over to Gilbert on the wing. Gilbert to the top of the key to Otto. Otto looking inside. She'll get it to Wookie. Wookie drives it baseline, puts it up, and it's blocked by Neuendorf. Now back inside after the clear and a hard foul by Neuendorf on the block.
Kind of a dumb play on that one, just jumping over top of her.
Klein will be shooting too. Tried to recover from the other side. Went up out of control. And Murray has two shots.
Third foul on the Royals.
First free throw is good. And checking in is McIntosh for Murray.
Murray's on a 5-0 run. So, now that they've gotten settled down, they're starting to play a little bit better.
Second free throw is good. 11-6. 6-0 run right now for Murray. 10 seconds left on the clock. It's going to be Neuendorf. Three in the corner. In and out, no good. Rebound controlled by Murray. If they push it, they can get one more shot here. I don't think they know what the clock is. And she gets it across half court. There will be no shot in the score after one. Colo-NESCO 11, Murray 6. Strong start for Colo-NESCO, but Murray finished that quarter with a 6-0 run. But the press forcing a lot of mistakes for Colo-NESCO, and very impressed with their defense so far in this game. About ready to get going here in the second quarter. Colo-NESCO leading 11-6. Again, strong start. Murray finished good. Colo-NESCO has been on target with their threes, but only one has fell. Now here's the pass to Stalzer in the corner now to Barton. Throws up a hook shot. It's wild. And Murray will go the other way with the ball. Otto pushes it forward, and she stepped out of bounds. Woo. It will go back to Colo-NESCO.
Murray getting a little too fast with it there. They outkicked their coverage on that play.
Back up top to Vincent here now to Stalzer on the wing. Cross-court pass to Henze. She'll take it baseline. Now back to Stalzer, a little wild pass, but she controlled it. Now to Robinson at the high post. And they're going to get a kick ball on Murray.
That was probably a good call.
Robbins is struggling at the high post here early. Now here's the kick to Stalzer. Now to Vincent in the corner. She'll try a three.
Nope.
And that'll bounce around, no good. And
foul call on Robinson. Murray still rebounding well, and that one caused a Royals foul.
Not many second chance opportunities at all for Colo-NESCO so far. Now here's the inbound. Bringing the ball up the floor is Sefkes. She'll turn around and get it to McIntosh. McIntosh to the top of the key to Otto. Now inside and to the short corner. Shot doesn't hit much, and Vincent the other way with it. And it's poked out of bounds by Otto. Just after half court.
Four fouls on the Royals, two on the Mustangs. Another turnover, pass intended to Neuendorf.
Bringing up the floor is Otto now. She crosses half court, gets it to McIntosh. McIntosh will get it to Sefkis. Now she'll get it into the field. Now to Otto, and it's stripped away by Stalzer and stolen by Stalzer. Now here comes Faith Vincent down the floor trying to push it. She'll pull it up. Now gets it to Neuendorf. Three ball on the way from Neuendorf, and it's no good. Rebound controlled by Gonsith, and here comes Murray the other way. Still looking for the first basket between both teams in the second quarter here. Sith casts now to McIntosh. McIntosh to Otto. Otto back to Sifkus, and now here's the inside pass. Good pass, and shot up, no good, but Gonsith will have two free throws coming.
Madison Gonsith looks like the best player for the Mustangs. She's a good, solid rebounder and strong down low.
Here's the first free throw on the way from Gonsith. First free throw is good.
I do have a header down in here. It has her name on her, I think. She's the points per game average. So if you can find it, it's one person talent.
Second free throw on the way. Bounces around and it's good.
Madison Gonsith averages about 15 points a game.
Now here's a handoff to Robinson. Robinson looks inside, gets it to Neuendorf. Oh, might have got away with a foul there from Murray, and here comes the Mustangs the other way after the Neuendorf air ball. There's a kick back up to the top of the key. Pass inside, stolen back away by Neuendorf. Now back to Hensley. Hensley's going to bring it up the floor with Vincent out of the game. Now gets it to Neuendorf. Out to Robinson in the corner. Robinson is going to bring it up to the top and gets it to Hensley. Colo-NESCO trying to slow it down a bit. Here's the pass inside to Barton. Tries getting a post move back out to Neuendorf. Now to Hensley. Wild pass. And they're going to try and get to the ball. And
Royal
over and back will
Mustangs
be called on Colo-NESCO. Not a very smart pass by Neuendorf out of the wing there. Here's the inbound to McIntosh. McIntosh. And here's a pass inside to Gonsith, back outside. Now to McIntosh, now back inside to Gonsith. Nice move on the post there by Gonsith. And it's an 11-10 game. Only a one-point game now. Murray started out down 11-0. Here's a three ball on the way from Neuendorf. And it'll bounce over the backboard. Out of bounds, back to Murray. Since the beginning of that first quarter, Murray has taken control of this ball game. Bringing it down the floor is McIntosh. Catches a screen that gets it back outside to Klein. Klein makes a move and another block by Neuendorf for second of the game. Now here's Hensley bringing it down the floor, gets it to Rachel Vincent, crosses up, gets in the line,
loses
lost
it.
Control of the ball, and it's stolen back away by Murray. Here come the Mustangs.
Murray playing good defense after the first few minutes of the game. Got him right back in it.
Here's the pass to the left wing. Now back up to the top of the key. Here's a feed to the wing now inside. Gonsith up off the glass and in.
Timeout Cafferty.
Gonsith has found her tempo now, and Murray takes a 12-11 lead and a timeout called by Colo-NESCO.
This is the Pioneer Ethanol Hybrid Come and Go. Casey's John Deere sponsor timeout. Colo-NESCO started the game on a 11-0 run. Murray's responded with a 12-0 run of their own to take the lead. Murray's coach, Jerry Shields, started off the game very hot, yelling at his players. And now, with his team up by one, doesn't have a whole lot to yell about.
Now the Royal Power chant going back and forth between the student section and the rest of the crowd. Crowd very well into it tonight. Rightfully so. We got a good game on our hands here. 12-11. Murray leads with 4:11 left in the first quarter as we get play started up again. There's the handoff to Robinson. Gets it inside to Stalzer. She had a nice pass to Barton. I don't know if Barton knew it was coming there, and it's knocked back out of bounds to Colo-NESCO.
Loose double team on Barton.
There's Stalzer on the wing. Now to Vincent, the cornerback to Stalzer. Henze's going to try three. In and out, no good. They're just not falling here for Colo-NESCO. And Murray the other way with the basketball. There's McIntosh now inside to Gonsith. Gonsith now back outside to McIntosh. Here's Klein at the top of the key now. She'll get it inside. Turn around, jumper on the way. In and out, no good from Myers. And here comes Vincent down the floor. Now kicks to Henze, back to Vincent. Steps into her shot, now gets it back over to Stalzer. Back to Stalzer on the wing. Cross-court pass to Henze. Inside feed, tipped away by Gonsith, but stolen back away by Henze. Here's Vincent at the top of the key. Colo-NESCO needs a basket desperately right now. And the pass is out of bounds. It was tipped last by Gilbert. And Colo-NESCO will retain possession.
Murray starting to finally settle down and play more what you would think a style of game they would want to play.
Vincent's three might have hit net, and it'll go out of bounds to Murray.
Colo plays their best when they're running their posts, running their press, and playing fast, forcing turnovers.
Murray has definitely slowed down the game now. McIntosh will get it to Klein now. Gonsith now to McIntosh. Mid-range jumper, no good.
Wow.
Gonsith fights for the rebound, puts it right back up and in. Draws the foul and one for Gonsith. She is controlling the paint right now as she'll have a free throw coming. 14-11, 2:43 left in the second quarter. Murray leads.
Fouls on Molly Barton. It's her second. Six fouls on the Royals in the first half, two for the Mustangs.
Colo-NESCO has not gotten the ball through the hoop in a very long time. And one from Gonsith, rolls around the hoop and falls through. And now here's Vincent the other way. Colo-NESCO needs something to happen right now. Now you're back up to the top of the key to Vincent. Back to Neuendorf. Neuendorf dribbles Stalzer's way. Now the dribble weave handoff. Back outside to Vincent, and it's tipped away and stolen away. Ball on the floor. She rolled around with it. Should have been a travel, but they're going to call a foul on Vincent.
Shooting 1-1 now for Mustangs. Crowd starting to get uneasy.
Colo-NESCO crowd really wants a travel on that play.
It's getting hot in here. Panic is ensuing.
1-1 free throw coming on the way for Gilbert.
Second foul on Faith Vincent.
First free throw on the way is long, and the rebound controlled by Stalzer. Here come the Royals.
Good.
The other way.
Royals trying to go fast.
Big possession for Colo-NESCO right here. Here's Vincent now to Barton in the corner. Back up top to Faith Vincent. Now out to Grace Stalzer to Michaela Neuendorf in the corner. Back out to Vincent. Vincent gets it to Stalzer. Corner three on the way. It's long. And the rebound tracked down by Vincent, and she's fouled.
Oh, foul here. Yep.
And they're going to call it on the floor. Good drive by Vincent there.
2:01 left in the first half. Pretty entertaining game.
Here's the inbound feed from Vincent. Gets it.
Turn it over again.
Not a good pass.
Oh, God.
It's cleared by Gonsith, and here comes Murray the other way with the basketball. They'll get it to Wookie on the wing. Now back up top to Klein. Now to Wookie. Now gets it to Gonsith. She'll put up a mid-range jumper. It's long. Rebound tracked down by Neuendorf. Back to Vincent. Pass up ahead and turn back over to Murray. Rachel Vincent couldn't control the pass, and she tips it out of bounds. Chelsea Hensley will check in now for Faith Vincent. Here's the inbound now. Here's Otto now, pushes it ahead to Wookie here now into the corner. Back outside. Inside now, Gonsith puts up a shot, might have been partially blocked. And a little bit of pressure from Gonsith. Hensley pushes it ahead, and it's tipped out of bounds by Otto, and it'll go back to Colo-NESCO. We're down to a minute 11 left in the half. Murray holds a 15-11 lead. Here's Stalzer, gets in into Hensley. Catches a screen from Rachel Vincent. Now to Neuendorf. She'll put up a three. They need this one. It's long.
No good.
And the rebound is controlled by Murray. Here come the Mustangs, and it's stolen away by Vincent. And she misses a huge layup on the other end. And it'll be knocked out of bounds back to Murray. Big missed opportunity for Colo-NESCO.
Under a minute left in the first half.
Now here's the inbound, and Vincent strips the ball away again. Ball's loose on the floor. And they're going to give a foul to Vincent there as she fell on the floor and accidentally tripped Wookie. And Wookie will be shooting a 1-1.
It's the eighth foul called on the Royals in the first half.
First free throw of the 1-1 is good, and it's a 16-11 game.
Royals are 15 seconds away from being shut out for the first time for a quarter this year.
Second free throw is on the way, and it's long, and the rebound tracked down by Neuendorf. Gonsith was in pursuit there. Here's Hensley now. Gets it to Neuendorf. Now to Stalzer, back to Hensley. Hensley down to the corner to Neuendorf. That'll be a two, and it's good. Finally, Colo-NESCO breaks the ice in the second quarter, and it's a 16-13 game. Colo-NESCO needs a stop here. Here's the pass into the wing. Wookie now, guarded by Vincent. Colo-NESCO in a 2-3 zone here. Here's Vincent. Now here's a pass to Wookie. Lost
almost
control of it.
It.
She's guarded closely by Hensley. Now here's McIntosh. Crosses over. Now gets it back up to Wookie. Here's a pass
Five
onto the
seconds.
Wing to Klein.
Four.
Three on the clock.
Two. One. It'll
shot
nope.
up is very short. No good. And at the end of the first half, the score is Murray 16, Colo-NESCO 13. Murray holding Colo-NESCO to only 2 points in the entire second quarter. Very good defensive effort by both teams up to this point. But Murray really pulled through there in the second quarter. Not much scoring coming from the Mustangs. But like I've made very clear, defense has been the difference here.
Colo-NESCO starting off playing their game with some fast-paced offense and good full court press, forcing turnovers. And that completely changed for about the last 12 minutes of game. Hasn't really been Colo-NESCO's game anymore. It's been really slow paced and good defense played by Murray and good rebounding by them as well. Here.
You do one.
All right. Get a camera.
I'll go get them.
Stalls. I want to get the camera on this here.
Well, for our halftime entertainment tonight, we got Michael Starling here, leader of the student section down there. How's the atmosphere down there, Michael?
Oh, it's great. It's great. We got a lot of positive vibes down there. Like you said, we got to have a lot of energy. That's key tonight.
Sounds pretty noisy from up here. It looks like a lot of energy, like you said. What does it look like going into these future games here? What are you looking to do?
Well, We're looking to do our job down there in the student section, making much noise and try to throw the team off as much, the other team off as much as we can. Try to be there, giving our team some support, and be with them through the thick and the thin.
Well, I mean, it's kind of pretty obvious, but what's the get up tonight for?
Oh, a little beach theme going on here. It may be cold here, but we still got good vibes. We still got good energy.
All right. How's the game looking from where you're sitting?
Well, it's looking great. I think we need to tweak some things at halftime. We need to not throw the ball away as much, but I think we're doing fine.
Well, keep up the good work. That's all we have for you right now.
Thanks.
Keep it up.
Thanks.
Now we got Brandon Jacobs. He's another student section guy tonight. Well, Brandon, you've been to, from what I've seen, you've been to at least 90% of the games this year.
Yes, sir.
The easy ones to make it to. How's both of the girls' and the boys' seasons look from your point of view tonight?
Well, the girls' season's looking pretty good until about, I don't know, a half hour, 45 minutes ago when they stopped scoring. The boys' season's looking really good, and we're going to the state, and we're going to win. Steven's going to dunk it.
Well, we'll see about that. well, it looks like I was talking to Michael. It's looking pretty noisy tonight, but the noisiest we've seen all night. Is that true from down where you're sitting?
I think so. I got a pretty good headache going on right now.
Well, that's always good.
Might have to go get some ibuprofen. I don't know.
I've noticed it's a pretty good relationship between the students and the rest of the crowd usually. Some nice chants going back and forth. Of course, you got Chris Barton on the other side. He's usually definitely a voice out there. What's your opinion on the crowd as a whole?
I think we got great fans here at Colo-NESCO. I think all the faces, they've been at about all the games I've been at and probably some more than that. Chris Barton, you're going to have to give him a shout-out. You know, he's a great fan. He's really loud. He takes it way back to the high school days of his student section days.
All right. Well, that's all we got for you tonight. Thank you, Brandon.
Yeah.
Keep yelling. Make some noise out there, bud. All right, I'm going to turn it over to Elliot Morgan. He's got some interviews with some boys basketball players.
All right, I'm joined by Christian Reischauer. Welcome.
Thanks for having me.
All right, we feel that you're not appropriately dressed, so we have some Lays for you. These are homegrown from Hawaii, and sorry about that. So far you have 1,000 points on the season, almost 1,100. Yep. How do you feel about that, reaching that milestone?
It's a great milestone to have, but it's I'd rather have a team milestone than a personal one.
And what is that team milestone that you want?
To make it to state and then win it.
Yeah, sounds good. Well, you guys have a really good team so far. You're number one in the state. You have Iowa Christian Academy coming in on Thursday. And then potentially after that, looks like Ankeny Christian the following Tuesday. How do you feel about going up against your stepfather?
It'll be fun. Definitely a little household rivalry right now until the game. So hopefully he's able to stay in the house after the game.
Yeah. Hopefully he could stay off the couch, right?
Yeah.
How do you feel about the first half of this game? Rolls down by three.
We went on a nice run in the beginning, and then they went on a run. So now we're just going to have to answer back. Might be a game of runs.
Yep. You're almost at 500 rebounds as well. You're a complete player. You look great. You're a physical specimen. And it's been a pleasure watching you these 4 years.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, we have to get another interview in right before half. Is there anything you want to say to the fans? Maybe a shout-out to somebody before
shout
we go?
Shout-out to the student section. They're the ones keeping us in this.
Exactly. Well, this is Elliot Morgan with Christian Reischauer saying, Mele Kaliki Maka, we are going to sign off right now, and I'm going to turn it over to Stephen Cutler, and we'll have Christian Montgomery back up in the booth. And thank you, Christian, for coming up.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, peace.
Well, once he gets back ready here, we got Christian Montgomery back up in the booth for the second week in a row here. He had a really dang good interview last time, so we decided to bring him back for another one. Well, Christian, it's been, what has it been, 4 or 5 days since we last talked to you. We'll talk about the boys' team first. What's practice been looking like lately?
Practice over this week has been good. We've just been fine-tuning some things, working on some things that we know we need to correct, and so we're ready for districts. And, you know, well, we've taken practice real well. You know, everyone's, I think, getting better, and we're just going to see how it pays off over this district run, and hopefully, you know, make it to state.
All right, senior year, you got 7 games left max right now. What's the emotion like with the 6 seniors on the team?
You know, I think we're just trying to take it 1 game at a time, and we're gonna live it up in the moment. You know, I mean, it's sad realizing that the end's almost here, but we're just gonna try and live in the moment right now and play our best so we don't have to have the season end right now, and hopefully get the ultimate goal and go win a state title, because that's about as good as you can go off.
Well, since the last time we talked to you, boys played another game against Dunkerton. It was a makeup game. Throttled them. But not much energy in the gym that night. What was that game like to play in?
You know, it was just one of those games that, you know, we knew we had to come in and stay focused, you know, and just take care of business. You know, it was on a Saturday. I guess not as many people were here because they knew it wasn't as big of a game, and, you know, might have had things going on. But, you know, we stayed focused, and we stuck to our plan, and we just went out and took care of business.
Well, conference win streak now is enormous. I don't have the number right in front of me right now, but it's been a solid more than 2 years since Colo-NESCO boys have lost a conference game. And this will be the last question right before we leave. But how has it felt playing in the Iowa Star Conference past 4 years?
Oh, it's great, you know. I love going up against, you know, some of the great athletes and teams that we have in this conference, you know, and playing with the guys on our team and, you know, going out and taking care of business every night, you know, and that's why the win streak shows what it is right now.
Okay, thank you, Christian.
Yep, thank you.
Go be loud.
All right, thank you.
All right, now we're about ready to go here in the second half. Colo-NESCO only dropped 1 bucket in the entire second quarter, so they'll be trying to come out with a little more energy than that. Down 16-13 to Murray. And we pretty much have our starters for both teams back on the floor. Here we go. We got 2 quarters left before we see who gets to move on and who gets to go back home. Winner advances to a game in Seidel against the winner of the Grandview game. Now here's the feed to McIntosh on the wing. Now back up to the top, the key to Klein, back to McIntosh. McIntosh drives baseline, now kicks it to Klein. Now over to Siegfried, and now back outside to McIntosh. McIntosh now inside. Colo-NESCO, good interior defense here. Now here's a shot up by Gonsith, and it's good right through. And it's an 18-13 game now. Colo-NESCO pushes it back up the floor again. Gonsith has went off since that Colo-NESCO run to start the game. Here's a 3-ball on the way from Stalzer, and it's good. Grace Stalzer gets things going in the second half for Colo-NESCO, bringing it down to an 18-16 Murray lead. Now here's the full court press by Colo-NESCO. Neuendorf pressuring ball. Siefkas now passes over to the side to Klein. Klein up to the top to McIntosh, back to Siefkas. Siefkas to the top of the key to Klein. Now to McIntosh, cross-court pass is wild.
Turnover.
And Colo-NESCO will regain control of the basketball.
We'd like to thank Michael Starling, Brandon Jacobs, Christian Montgomery, and Christian Reischauer for all taking time for some halftime interviews. We had a full lineup tonight, 4 interviews. It's a record.
Neuendorf, turnaround jumper's good, and Colo-NESCO ties it right back up with 6:36 left in the third quarter. Now here's Murray looking to answer that. McIntosh bringing it up the floor for the Mustangs. She'll get it to Sefkis. Now Sefkis to Klein, now to McIntosh. McIntosh back up to Sefkis. Sefkis looking inside back to McIntosh. She drives the baseline. Now takes it back outside. Here's Klein, puts up a shot and is blocked by Barton. Cleared by Neuendorf. And she pushes it up ahead to Vincent. Here's Faith Vincent now at the top of the key. Going to look for a set play. Now gets it to Neuendorf. She looks inside. Now gets it back up to Vincent. Cross-court pass to Neuendorf. Wide open three from Neuendorf, and it's good. Colo-NESCO jumps out to a 21-18 lead to start the second half. Neuendorf with a nice three in the corner. Now here's Murray pushing it the other way. And a double dribble by Klein, and that'll turn it right back over for Colo-NESCO.
Quick start for the Royals coming out of the half. They're on a 7-2 run.
Two huge three-pointers there by Colo-NESCO. Now here comes Vincent down the floor to Robinson. Now to Stalzerp, inside pass, and it's a kick ball by McIntosh. Colo-NESCO will take it out now underneath the baseline. Vincent. Bound. Here's Henze flashing into the corner. Now gets it to Robinson. Puts up a shot and it's short. And here comes Murray the other way. Now here's a toss to Wookie. Wookie drives in, loses control, and she was fouled.
Another foul on the Royals. This will be their ninth in the game, I believe.
They will give it to Chelsea Henze.
They had eight fouls in the first half. One so far. Steal by Molly Barton.
Here's Vincent bringing it up the other way. Oh, she missed Henze open underneath the hoop. Now here's a cross-court pass to Henze, and she overthrew her, but Henze saves it back inside. But it's taken back away by Wookie. Here comes Murray the other way. Drive in. No good on the layup by Wookie. And here's Stalzer with the rebound. She's bringing it back up the floor. She'll slow it up on the wing. Gets it inside to Robinson. Robinson kick out Vincent. Three ball on the way from Vincent. Rolls in, and Colo-NESCO jumps out to a 24-18 lead. Three big three-pointers by Colo-NESCO here, along with a mid-range field goal, has put them up 6 points on Murray. Here's the inside pass to Gonsith. She puts it off the glass. No good, and the rebound controlled by Stalzer. Now here's Vincent. Now to Stalzer, back to Vincent. Rotates it to Henze, now to the high post is Robinson. Her shot's blocked, but Stalzer controls the rebound, kicks it back out. Henze for three now. No good on that shot, and the rebound controlled by Gonsith. Here comes Murray the other way. Here's Otto, now gets it inside. Klein, shot up, no good. Excuse me, that was Gonsith. Now back outside to McIntosh. McIntosh over to Wookie. Wookie trying to look inside, now kicks it over to Otto. Now back to Wookie. Wookie on the wing, back up to McIntosh to Otto. Otto beyond the three-point arc. Back to Wookie. To McIntosh, and Barton blocks Gonsith again. Barton with her second block in the half.
Colo-NESCO playing much better to start the second half, throwing 11-2 run right now. Faith Vincent coming out. Grace Stalzer coming out. Neuendorf and Rachel Vincent are coming in for the Royals.
Here's the inbound. That gets it to McIntosh on the wing. She fires it over to Wookie. Now the inside pass to Gonsith. She'll dribble it back outside. Now back over to Wookie. Now to McIntosh. She almost lost control of the ball, and Vincent was right there. Now here's Gonsith on the high post. Back out to Wookie. Putting up a shot is... Excuse me, Wookie put up the shot, and she gets it in, and one. She'll have a free throw coming.
Another foul called on the Royals. Got a little bit too much contact there on the shots on Cassie Robinson, her second. A bunch of Royals with two fouls so far.
Here's the only free throw coming on the way, and it's good from Wookie. Cutting it down to a three-point game now. 3:30 left in the third quarter. We got a good one on our hands here as Barton in the corner back out to Henze. Henze spins, gets it to Vincent. Three ball on the way from Rachel. Vincent rolls off the front of the rim, no good. And here comes McIntosh the other way with the basketball. McIntosh fires it on the wing. Now inside, Gonsith, short-range jumper. It's short.
Wow, good
rebound. Controlled by Klein. Her shot short, too. And Colo-NESCO clears the rebound finally, pushing it up the floor. Back to Henze on the wing. Now to Neuendorf. Pump fakes, drives in a bit, puts up a mid-range jumper. No good, and the rebound controlled by Klein. Klein now the other way. She'll handle the ball up the floor. Now gets it to McIntosh on the key. And Wookiee lost control of the basketball. Henze grabs it now. Here's Vincent in transition. One-on-one. Layup up. Rolls around and it's good.
Woo!
26-21. Colo-NESCO leads. 2:33 left to play in the third quarter. Now here's the pass to Gonsith. Up off the glass. Might have been partially blocked. Battle for the rebound. Won by Rachel Vincent. And that gets it to Chelsea Henze. Henze now on the wing. Cross-court pass to Neuendorf. Neuendorf pump fakes. Now back outside to Barton. Now to Robinson. Colo-NESCO slowing down a bit here. Now kicks out to Vincent. Now to Henze. To Neuendorf. She's going to pull that trigger. It's short. And it'll be... Rebound was lost control by McIntosh right into Cassie Robinson's hands, who finishes it with a layup. And it's 28-21 Colo-NESCO.
It's like the Royals might have got away with a foul there on the baseline. And we'll have a timeout taken by Jerry Shields.
Colo-NESCO coming out with a lot more life here in the third quarter. Threes finally starting to fall now for the Royals.
We have some sort of interaction going on in the student section, the front row there. It's like Kevin Hapes right in the center of it. Good swing of events for the Royals here in the third quarter. They are on a 15-5 run.
Now here's the inbound. Sivkis with the ball, now gets it to Gilbert. Now the inside pass. Here's Gonsith, puts up a shot, and she'll be fouled. Two shots coming for Gonsith.
Another foul on the Royals. It's on McKinley Neuendorf.
Colo-NESCO yet to have free throws tonight.
It's Neuendorf's second foul, the team's third. Free throw's brick.
Here's a second free throw from Gonsith on the way. It's no good. Oh, that one's good. And it's 28-22. Colo-NESCO leads. Here's Stalzer now. Gets it to Neuendorf. Kick outside. Faith Vincent for three. Wow! That one's good. 31-22. Faith Vincent was deep there, about 2 feet behind the three-point line. Now here comes Murray the other way. Cross-court pass now. He's a drive inside. Kicks it back up to McIntosh. Now here's Sivkis. Back to Gilbert, now to McIntosh. Sivkis, McIntosh. Now cross-court pass, here's Sivkis. Puts up a short-range jumper. Might have been partially blocked, and it's out of bounds. They don't think it was partially blocked, and it will go back to Colo-NESCO.
Under a minute left in the third quarter. Royals are up by 9 now. We're down by 3 at halftime.
Here's Neuendorf on the wing. Cross-court pass to Vincent. Vincent gets it inside to Cassie Robinson. Now over to Grace Stalzer, and she's fouled. Two shots coming on the way for Stalzer.
Foul was on Mackenzie McIntosh for the Mustangs.
Grace First free throw on the way is no good from Grace Stalzer, and Molly Barton, Chelsea Hensley will check in now for Colo-NESCO. Second free throw on the way is good.
10-point lead for the Royals. Momentum is almost all in their corner right now. Press is working right now for the Royals.
Stahl's got a hand on that pass. And here's Seifkus bringing it down the floor, not the best ball handler from Murray. Here's Gilbert. She'll throw up a long-range two. It's no good, and the rebound controlled by Robinson. Robinson will give it to Vincent. Now pushes it ahead to Hensley. Hensley, and she was fouled by Gilbert. .32-22, Colo-NESCO leads with 23 seconds left in the third quarter.
It's the third foul on Brandy Gilbert. Good inbounds pass, gets it blocked. That was a good inbounds pass to Cassie Robinson. It was blocked by the Mustangs.
Here's McIntosh at the top of the key now to Gilbert. Gilbert drives in, puts up a wild shot, no good. But Gonsith got the rebound, puts back up off the glass and in. That feeds inside Barton off the glass. No good. Last second shot won't fall. And it's 32-24 at the end of the third quarter. We're going to the last period of play with Colo-NESCO up by 8.
And Colo-NESCO cheerleaders have the student section marching to the beat. In that quarter, we had a lot of bellowing from Chris Barton, as usual. He might have stepped it up a notch in that third quarter.
And now we're about ready to get going with the final quarter of play. Colo-NESCO holding an 8-point lead. Winner plays at Seidel in the next round. Now here's Stalzer. Stalzer gets it to Neuendorf. She'll try a three, and it's good! Michaela Neuendorf with another three, and it's 35-24. Colo-NESCO leads. A wild pass by Murray is out of bounds, and Colo-NESCO will get it right back.
Really good swing events for the Royals.
Press forcing all sorts of mistakes from Murray here in the second half. And here's the inbound to Vincent, bringing it across the timeline. Gets it to Neuendorf, back up to Vincent. Vincent gets it to Hensley now. Hensley on the wing, cross court pass, inaccurate. Now gets cleared by Colo-NESCO, back to Hensley, gets it to Stalzer in the paint, now back out to Neuendorf, to Faith Vincent at the top of the key, now to Neuendorf, she'll fake a three, now to Stalzer in the corner, inside pass to Barton, back outside to Neuendorf, here's Faith Vincent trying a three, and that one's good! Colo-NESCO going off from beyond the arc here in the second half, and it's 38-24, Colo-NESCO leads. 7:06 left to play in the fourth quarter.
Royals are on a 25-8 run.
Barton gets a block down low, cleared right back away by Seifkus. Now up top to McIntosh. Now here's Otto, fakes. Oh, she got away with a travel, puts up a three. It's no good. And now here's McIntosh, feed inside to, and they're going to get a foul on Barton. So Gonsith will have two shots coming here.
It's good for the Mustangs. They need to score, and it helps when the clock is stopped when they have the opportunity to score. It's the third foul on Barton. Looks like Cassie Robinson's going to check in for her.
First free throw is good from Gonsith.
It's 6:42 left in the fourth quarter.
Second free throw by Gonsith is good. And it's 38-26, Colo-NESCO leads. Here's Neuendorf back to Vincent. She'll bring it across half court, now gets it to Neuendorf. Neuendorf beyond the arc, now gets it to back to Vincent, puts up a short-range jumper. No good, and the rebound controlled by Gonsith. Bringing it down the floor, now here's McIntosh. McIntosh back to Otto on the wing. Otto looking inside, now kicks it back out. Seifkiss back to McIntosh, now to Otto. To Seifkiss, she'll put up a long two, and it's good. Cut down to a 10-point lead now. 6:06 left to play in the game. Here's Vincent. And a timeout will be called by Coach Cafferty.
And some more bellowing from Chris Barton now. Not sure what he's saying.
This definitely looks like one of the better games the Colo-NESCO girls have played this season. Despite the second quarter stretch of no offense, the defense has been phenomenal.
Some chance of MHS coming from the small and pathetic Murray student section.
A little bit of hostility between the two.
Colo-NESCO student section is sitting down. And Chris Barton yells, "Here we go, Royals!"
Classic. Now here's Colo-NESCO to inbound as the section rises back up. And here's Vincent at the top of the key, gets it inside. Neuendorf, turnaround, jumper is good. Neuendorf going off tonight on Murray. 40-28, Colo-NESCO leads. Here's the kick, McIntosh beyond the arc. She's looking inside. She wants to get it to Gonsith. They'll get it to Gonsith now. She turns around right into the hands of Barton, who collects another block. Now here's Faith Vincent. Vincent picks it up, now gets it to Robinson. Kick outside, and they're going to call a travel on Robinson.
12-point lead for the Royals, 5:34 left in the final quarter of action.
There's Murray defeated inbounds against the Colo-NESCO press, which is still there, and Rachel Vincent knocked it out of bounds. Good heads-up defense there. There's the inbound, getting it to Klein. Klein crosses over, almost got her pocket picked by Stalzer. Klein drives right to the hoop, though, and puts up a shot. It's good. 40-30, 5:24 left in the game. Now here's Stalzer in the corner. Drives a bit, cross-court pass to Rachel Vincent. Three ball in the way from Rachel, no good. And the rebound controlled by Grace Stalzer. And she is tied up in a jump ball by Gonsith.
A lot of booing here from the Colo-NESCO crowd. It's getting hot, it's getting stuffy. Panic is ensuing.
Kind of a 50-50 call there, could have gone either way. And this is a crossover, and they're going to call a travel on Wookie.
It's amazing how quick the referees could go from being your worst enemies to your best friends.
Here's the inbound by Henze with Vincent out of the game. Now here's the pass. Now here's Henze in the corner. Three ball is short and the rebound controlled by Gonsith. Murray tries to go the other way. It's going to be Otto with the ball. She stops, not in a very good place, but she gets it ahead to Wookie. Now here's a shot by McIntosh.
Wow.
It rolls in and good. Murray sticking around here. 8-point lead for Colo-NESCO. Stalzer pulls up, now gets it to Henze. Henze to Rachel Vincent in the corner, back out to Chelsea. Henze inside to Robinson. She gets it to Barton. Barton fades away, jump, no good. Another offense rebound by Stalzer. Kicks it out to Robinson. Mid-range jumper, no good. Rebound again by Stalzer.
Good job.
Stalzer out to Henze. Now to Vincent, back to Henze. Henze inside to Robinson. Turnaround jumper rolls out, no good. And a battle for the rebound is controlled by... Timeout called by Colo-NESCO, so Colo-NESCO will control that possession as Rachel Vincent managed to grab the rebound out of that mess.
The referee is signaling to the Murray coach, Jerry Shields, that it will be Murray's basketball coming out of the timeout. They did control the jump ball there. .412 left. Murray sticking around, not going anywhere. They were down by 12 or 14, I believe, and now they hold it within a three-score game.
Well, Colo-NESCO handled Ankeny Christian very well in the last round, but definitely a little more of a challenge for them here in the second round. This will be the girls' last home game. Regardless,
the boys will start their playoff run on Thursday here at around 8 o'clock. We could guess that tip off could be more towards 8:15 or 8:20. Should be a pretty competitive game between Colfax Mingo and Twin Cedars Bussy at 6:30.
And here's the inbound from Vincent. Vincent gets it to Neuendorf. She lost control of the basketball, cleared by Henze, though. And now she gets it inside to Salzer, back to Robinson now. Here's Faith Vincent on the wing.
Royals.
Vincent's back in after getting some bench time.
Royals trying to kill some clock here. Coach Cafferty telling him to bring it back out to kill clock. Henze's shot's no good. Rebound by, looked like Grace Stalzer came up with it, but then a Murray player came out of the dust.
And on the wing, driving in his Wookiee, and they're going to get a foul on Neuendorf there. Like, two shots on the way from Wookiee.
It's like Neuendorf might have yelled an expletive as she gets called for a foul. It's her third, team's fifth.
First free throw on the way from Wookiee. Rolls around good. Barton comes in for Robinson now. Barton's played some very good lockdown D on Gonseth here in the second half as the second free throw is good from Wookiee.
6-point game. Royals looking like they're wanting to go fast here. Turn it over. Oh, my God.
Neuendorf couldn't control the pass. Now here comes McIntosh down the floor.
It's not what they needed to do there. They needed to kill clock.
And here's a pass up top to Wookiee. Wookiee to the wing to McIntosh. McIntosh looking inside. They want to get it inside to Gonseth here, you can tell. And here's Wookiee back outside to McIntosh. Here's a three on the way from Otto. No good.
Oh,
and Grace,
man.
Stalzer lost control of the rebound. And it goes back out of bounds to Murray. 3:06 left to play in the fourth quarter. Colo-NESCO holds a 40-34 lead.
Oh my God!
Gonseth threw it off the back of the Royal defender and got a layup out of it. Now only a 4-point game after that play. Here's Neuendorf getting it to Gonseth, and a foul will be called on number 23, Madison Gonseth, on that play. So Neuendorf will have two free throws on the way. Very good heads-up play there by Gonseth on the inbound.
Bad series of plays by the Royals. The effort was there. The execution certainly wasn't.
First free throw is good by Neuendorf. Second free throw by Neuendorf. That one's good.
It's now back to a 6-point game.
Colo-NESCO trying to hold this lead here with the last 2:48 left.
Under 3 minutes left in the game.
Here's Otto on the wing. Otto, cross-court pass, almost stolen away by Stalzer there. Now here's a pass inside, open shot, no good. And Colo-NESCO clears it. Here's Vincent down the floor. Cafferty calling for some
oh
clock
my
killing,
goodness,
but
hold on
Colo-NESCO
to the ball.
Lost control of the ball again. Another turnover.
That one was by Molly Barton.
Now here's the cross court pass now. McIntosh looking inside, can't find it one. That gets back out to Otto. He's worked, puts up a shot, and it's good.
4-point game. Under 2 minutes left.
Vincent now brings it across half court. She'll reverse out of a screen. Now she'll get it to Vincent. Now back to Faith Vincent. Here's Neundorf, pump fakes, driving in. Cross paint pass, Barton, layup off the glass, no good. Grabs her own rebound, puts it back in. Colo-NESCO back up 6.
A minute and a half left. Murray doesn't like to shoot threes. That means they'll need 3 shots to tie it.
Oh, Vincent tied it up there.
Almost a foul there by Rachel. Be careful.
Now here's McIntosh at the top of the key. Now into the wing, almost pulled the trigger on a 3 ball. She'll drive in, pull a long 2, no good. Rebound, though, by Klein. No good on her shot.
Go!
And the rebound controlled by Colo-NESCO.
Go!
Faith Vincent to the basket.
Oh,
no good.
Lord.
Rebound controlled by Rachel Vincent. Kicks it back out to Neundorf.
Hold it.
1 minute left to play, and they're going to foul Faith Vincent.
A minute 0-2 left in the game. Royals lead 44-38. It's getting hot and heated up here in the press booth. We'll have a timeout called by Jerry Shields.
Game just got a little messy on the floor there for time period, so they're going to call a timeout here. Colo-NESCO holds a 6-point lead. And not in free throw situation yet for Colo-NESCO, but that's never stopped them from turning it over before on the sidelines. So we'll see how this goes. On the inbounds.
Had an awful series of events there for the Royals. They missed a couple open shots. They turned it over again and again. And Murray had the basketball to inbounds under their own basket. What do? They throw it off the back of a Royal player and put it right up and in.
Heads up play on the inbounds.
Thursday night, Stephen Cutler, you'll be on the floor.
Yep.
And what's your prediction for that matchup?
We should pull it out pretty handily. That's what we expect from ourselves anyway.
That's what we like to hear.
Now here's the inbound now from Stalzer. Colo-NESCO needs to get the ball inbounds cleanly. They will, and they get to Vincent. Oh, and they stripped
it,
gotten away with a foul, and they will call a foul this time.
58-6 left in the game.
Still another foul to give for – still another 2 fouls to give for Murray.
They're doing that dumb spin play.
Hey, it works.
It does. Doesn't look good, but it works. I'll give him that, I guess.
It confuses defenses here, as just it did there. Oh, and a hard foul.
Tear up!
And they want a flagrant, and almost rightfully so. Well, they're not going to call that.
Boo!
It is a foul, and one more foul to give for Murray. Stalzer just got rammed there. Linebacker.
Cafferty calling for that spin play again. They're spinning around. Who's it going to be? Who are they going to throw it to? They'll throw it to Grace.
There's
again.
Stalzer. They're not. They're going to foul her.
Now they'll shoot.
And that's going to be Gilbert's last foul. She's out of the game after that.
So long. Gilbert being consoled by her coach, and Sifkis comes in.
Stalzer, front end's good. Big free throw there by Grace Stalzer. Now she'll look to really make it difficult with a second one, and it's good. Colo-NESCO now up 8 points on Murray. They need baskets and quick if they want to get,
oh, good inbounds,
get this
pass.
Game tied up again. Here's Klein. Now here's Wookie driving in. Puts up a shot off the glass. No good. Battle for the rebound controlled by Sifka, and she puts it off of the glass and in. And timeout will be called by Jerry Shields and Murray. 47-40, Colo-NESCO leads. Colo-NESCO has made the three ball fall here in the second half. Only got one to go in the first, but three of those coming from Mikaelin Neuendorf. One of the big reasons why they hold a 7-point lead right now. Now here's the inbound, the circle up play again, and they're going to get into Neuendorf without any trouble. Now they get it back to Vincent, and they're going to get a foul.
Royals are
on Otto.
Getting to the line, but Murray is doing good by fouling without much time coming off the clock.
Vincent will be at the line now. Free throw's no good. Kind of a big miss there, but we'll see how much it actually matters here as Murray brings it down the floor. Here's the inside pass, almost knocked away. Sifkis puts up a three, no short range shot, no good. Puts up another one.
Oh,
this
my
one's
goodness.
Good though. And it's now only down to a 4-point game.
21 seconds left.
It's got a little more interesting. Murray not going away. Never say die attitude right now and the right time to do that.
Well, if I was Murray, out of this timeout, I would come out guns blazing. Just, like, get right up in front of the person that's throwing in his face. Wave your arms as fast as you can and distract them, and then steal the ball.
Colo-NESCO is going to run that circle up inbounds play like they've been doing. It's almost impossible to guard on an inbounds play. You never know where your person is going. They break out of the circle. So, yeah, like Elliot just said, they want to get as much pressure on that inbounder as they can. They don't want to sag off of that. They want to make that inbound pass as difficult as possible. Murray only down four. Now, they have not made a single three, and they've only shot about two all night, so... Here's the inbound now from Vincent. She'll look, and good defense here by Murray. Gets in and
almost
turned it over. And they're going to get Neuendorf on a foul. She got belted by Gonsa, not the girl you want to get hit by. And she gets back up.
That was a good hard foul.
As usual, Colo-NESCO crowd calling for a tee after that.
They do after most fouls.
Now here is the free throw by Neuendorf. It's a 1-1. Front end is good. Big free throw there, makes it a 5-point game. Two possessions.
Kaylin Neuendorf with 20 points tonight.
Second free throw is good. And they're going to bring Neuendorf out after she got destroyed on the foul. Now here's the inbound. Murray's down six. Whether they like it or not, they need to shoot threes.
Looks like
they're not even going to try.
Here we go, 33 will take one.
Three.
Nope.
No good. Salzer almost lost it out of bounds, and we'll see what the ref calls
foul.
Here. They're going to call a foul.
6 seconds left
so
in the game.
So Salzer will have free throws coming now. And you can pretty much call that the end of the game now. 6-point lead for Colo-NESCO. 6 seconds left to play. Colo-NESCO will advance to the next round to play the winner of Grandview and Iowa Christian Academy. First free throw is no good from Stalzer. Second free throw now from Stalzer. That one's good, and it gives Colo-NESCO a 49-42 lead. Game's on ice now as Murray
Three,
brings it down the floor.
Two,
stolen away
one.
By Vincent. It doesn't matter. We're done here in Colo. Colo-NESCO pulling out the win, 49-42. They advance to the semifinals.
Good win for Colo-NESCO. They were down by three at half. They came out of the locker room, guns blazing, full swings, and got out to a big lead. And then Murray bounced back and brought it to a 4-point game a bunch of times. A lot of hard fouls there at the end.
That is the 20th win for Colo-NESCO. Well, the Grandview Iowa Christian Academy game is yet to be decided.
Would guess Grandview Christian would win that.
Well, big win for Colo-NESCO here tonight as they advance closer to their fourth straight state tournament. We'll be wrapping it up here tonight. Join the Colo-NESCO version of the NFHS Network on Thursday night as the Colo-NESCO boys host the Iowa Christian Academy Blazers here in Colo. That's it from us, Stephen Cutler.
This is Elliot Morgan, and we'll be back in action on Thursday night. It's to be determined who I'll be joined by. I'll be joined by Tony Stalzer in the booth again. That should be exciting. And hopefully we'll have somebody else on the camera. Maybe the person that's supposed to show up will actually show up for once, and we'll have a full crew. All right, thanks for stopping by, and we'll see you on Thursday. Good night.